Hi everyone, it's Brittany again from Esri Canada Technical Support. If you're looking for a refresher on how to transfer your ArcGIS desktop concurrent use licenses and extensions from one license manager environment to another, this is the video for you. Now, before you decide to transfer your concurrent licenses between servers, please make sure your new server machine meets the license server administrator system requirements for your desired version. When planning to transfer your licenses, there are four simple steps to follow. Number one, deauthorize all your concurrent use licenses that you'd like to transfer on your original license server. If you're hoping to completely decommission your original license server, you can go ahead and uninstall the ArcGIS license server administrator on the original license server. Number three, install ArcGIS license server administrator via MyEsri on your new server machine. And lastly, authorize all the licenses on the ArcGIS license server administrator in order to bring all of those licenses back. Step one, to deauthorize our concurrent licenses, we'll need to launch our original server machine's ArcGIS license server administrator as an administrator in order to make these changes. Navigate to the availability folder and make sure none of the licenses are currently being used. We can verify this by opening the View License Usage window and by going through the tabs to make sure none of the licenses have been borrowed, transferred, or checked out. You can see here, none of these licenses are being checked out. If they are and you're unable to reach the end user using this license, you can select Force Check-In. Then we can go to the start/stop license service in order to stop the license service. And in this, after this is clicked, none of the licenses are accessible by your end users anymore. Perfect. And now that the license server status is changed to not running, it is always safe to check and to confirm that all your licenses here are the ones that you're expecting. It is also safe to take a screenshot of these products in order to reauthorize the same products on your new license machine. Once that is done, we can go to the authorization folder and click deauthorize. For the sake of this demo, we will be deauthorizing via the internet. And as you can see here, the software authorization wizard specifically for deauthorization is popped up and will deauthorize via the internet. Here we can select all the products that we're hoping to deauthorize, as we are going to stick with all the desktop products. We will only select the ones that are applicable for the sake of this demo. So here I will deauthorize Desktop Basic, 3D Analyst, Spatial Analyst, and Network Analyst in order to reauthorize those in the new license server. And here, once we click Next, we will just wait for those licenses to get deauthorized. And once it is successful, we can click Finish. and it'll bring us back to the license server administrator. It'll take a couple seconds before the license service rereads what should be available. And here you can see all the ones I've deauthorized are no longer on this list. So the next step would be to uninstall your ArcGIS License Server Administrator. And for the sake of this demo, I won't do it, but you can remove the program via your control panel under your programs. Now let's move on to our new license machine. To install, please sign in to your MyESRI account. To install ArcGIS License Server Administrator on your license server, please sign in to your MyESRI account with downloads permissions. Navigate to My Organizations and select the Downloads tab. In here, you can select the desired version of ArcGIS Desktop. And let's scroll down to the License Manager items here. There is the Windows version as well as the Linux version, so you can download the correct one accordingly. And now we can click the Downloads button and finally run the downloaded program. Once installed, this is what the ArcGIS License Server Administrator looks like. Please make sure that you're running this application as an administrator in order to make necessary changes. Here you can authorize your concurrent use license product by clicking the authorization folder, by selecting the ArcGIS desktop version that you've installed, and by clicking the Authorize Now button. Now for the sake of this demo, we will be authorizing an ArcGIS desktop basic level for concurrent use and some commonly used extension products, which includes 3D Analyst, Spatial Analyst, and Network Analyst. So as we click Authorize Now, the Software Authorization Wizard pops up, and we're presented with three options. If you haven't authorized any licenses yet, select the first radio button that says, I need to authorize licenses on my license server. If you already authorized your licenses but want to add some more products, select the second radio button. And the third radio button is if you received a provisioning file and would like to expedite your authorization process. And we have another video coming out soon, so stay tuned. Then we'll need to select the core product that we are authorizing. And in this case, we're going to authorize an ArcGIS desktop license. So let's click Next. In this page, we will authorize with ESRI now using the internet. We'll click Next. Here we'll need to enter our information, specifically the fields with an asterisk. Once that is done, we can click Next. And here, the categories can be selected to the most applicable one to your field. Now we can enter our core license codes that begin with the letters EFL and paste it in their respective license levels. We'll also need to identify the quantity of licenses that is allocated to this particular license code. If you're unsure, you can check in your MyESRI account under My Organizations, under the Licensing tab, and in the View Authorizations option on the left. You can click the details on the desired product and delve into more details about your license, including your authorization code. Once you've done this, we can click Next. If we have any extensions to authorize, here's the chance to copy and paste those respective EFL codes next to the correct extension product. We'll have to select I have authorization numbers to authorize one or more extensions in order to enable this. paste some EFL codes. And identify the number of licenses that we hope to authorize available and attached to these license codes. Once that is done, we can click Next. And this is where we wait for the process to authorize the license. Once the authorization is processed, we can click Finish to close the Software Authorization Wizard window, which brings us back to the ArcGIS License Server Administrator. We'll wait while it rereads the license, and now we can verify that the license is now available under the Availability folder and that the license service is running, as shown below. If it is not running, we can click the Start Stop License Service and click Start to restart the license service. From there on, you can then reconnect your end user machine's ArcGIS administrator to the new license server machine. Make sure to take note of the new license server machine's name in order to do so. If you want a refresher on how to do that, please hop on over to our video about authorizing an ArcGIS desktop concurrent use license. So today, we covered the topic of transferring ArcGIS desktop concurrent use licenses and a few extensions from one license manager environment to another using four simple steps. Step 1, deauthorize all the applicable licenses on the original license server. Step 2, if you are decommissioning your license server, you can go ahead and uninstall the ArcGIS License Server Administrator. Step 3, uninstall ArcGIS License Server Administrator on your new license server machine via MyESRI. And step 4, you can authorize all the applicable licenses on your new license server. I hope you found this video helpful and that I debunked some ArcGIS desktop licensing myths for you. If so, please don't forget to like this video and feel free to leave comments and/or suggestions below. Lastly, if you want to see more ESRI Canada technical videos, you can subscribe to our channel using the subscribe button below. Happy mapping! Thanks for watching, and I'll see y'all next time.